SAT gods have smiled upon me, senior year is still way more stressful than I imagined. Choosing a college is no eeny, meeny, miny, mower. This decision will affect my entire destiny until I'm, like, 22. And it's not just me. Sean and Murray are obsessed with getting into the right college. I've never seen the two of them so motivated.
All right, our first plan of attack. We cross-reference all the girls of the Big Ten with all the girls from the top 10 party schools.
Huh. You cross, I'll reference. Oh, check out these Michigan State babes. Oh
man, you're crazy. Too cold equals too many layers. Brother, you can't get down and down.
You're right. Oh, how about summer school at the University of Miami?
Nah, man, that's just a bunch of rich kids.
Yeah, we'd never fit in. Is my Rolex slow or is the masseuse late?
Cher, I have found the perfect college for us. It couldn't be more perfect if it were called the University of Cher and Dionne.
That is so sweet. You put my name first.
If this place looks as good as it does in the catalog, I'm sold.
Hold it. You're picking our college from a catalog?
A real good one.
Dee, we can't choose a college from a catalog any more than we can choose clothes that way.
Exactly. Which is why I've taken the liberty of setting up an exhaustive, in-depth academic inspection.
You mean...
road trip!
What do you have?
Eight-ish.
Me too.
Okay, college boys in T minus 7 hours and counting.
Okay, here's your ticket. Window both ways. I'll be on the aisle.
Oh no. What if they put someone in the middle seat?
It's taken care of. I bought it just in case. I couldn't stand another gassy man episode.
You know, I had to burn that Prada blouse.
I had to cut my hair short.
Vultures. Amber, it's a Channel 11 news helicopter.
I know. Sweeps week.
Shoot.
All right, to what do we owe the horror?
I wanted your opinion so I could do the opposite.
Don't play in traffic.
Ignoring. Daddy's giving me an early graduation gift, either 2 weeks in Europe or the plastic surgery of my choice. Now, I'm leaning plastic.
Oh, I know a great plastic surgeon. He did Tori Spelling.
Find me one that didn't.
So what, are you just gonna pick a body part at random?
Well, I'm narrowing my choices. Now, I'm a perfect size 3, but if I had a few ribs removed, I could probably be a 1.
And if you had all of your ribs removed, you could probably be a beanbag chair.
Still ignoring. Now, I'm also considering those really pouty, bee-stung lips.
Ooh, like Pamela Anderson?
Oh, or not.
Okay, this is officially the longest day of my life. My first college weekend is so close, I can smell the frat boys. Oh, when is that bell going to toll for me?
Before I dismiss you dilettantes, I see that several of you have not picked a topic for your sociology term paper. Now, remember, this report represents 100% of your grade.
100%? Miss Sardell, that's not fair.
So I'm insane. Report me.
Man, Sean, if we don't find a topic quick, we can forget about the girls of the Big Ten. We're hanging out with the girls of the 7-Eleven.
I know.
Amber, how about you?
Sorry, plastic surgery pending. A lot on my mind.
Honey, I am the gatekeeper between you and the rest of your life. If you do not pass this class, you will not go to college. Even if Daddy donates a wing. So, what's he gonna be, princess?
Okay. I plan an exhaustive research study chronicling how society shows preference to beautiful people, especially those with enhanced traits, such as high cheekbones, full lips, or, say, a bigger chest.
Boob survey?
Count me in.
Miss Sardell?
Yes, Murray.
For our term paper, Sean and I will be assisting Amber with this groundbreaking research.
Yes, yes.
As if.
We'll do all the grunt work. Come on!
Fine. But I get to order you around and take out all my frustrations on you, just like a real boss.
Of course.
Fine.
Approved. Dionne, your topic?
Me.
Totally sold on Stanhope. I'm already living in the dorm.
Showering next to
Adam. Okay, tomorrow over here, poolside, smoothies and Stanhope applications.
Go squirrels! Hi, Daddy. Why do you have bed head?
You don't like it? It's my relaxed look. So, how was Stanhope?
Incredible. The halls were ringing with sounds of impassioned discourse, and the classrooms were filled with eager young sponges awaiting the wisdom of their esteemed professors.
Are the crappers still co-ed?
Daddy! What happened?
Oh, please! So I had some snacks.
A large pepperoni pizza's a snack?
In some cultures?
Yeah, Wisconsin. What happened to the low-fat dinners I left you?
Ah, they make great appetizers.
It's not funny. Dr. Rashkin said your cholesterol was sky high and your blood pressure is off the charts. Did you at least exercise?
Yes, 12-ounce reducing curls.
Then I suppose you forgot to take your blood pressure pills.
I'll double them up tomorrow.
Even better, Cole.
What was I thinking? There's no hope for Stanhope. I can't leave a father who has a fatal attraction to cheese. He'll explode. Sadly, I think it's goodbye, squirrels.
Sayonara, Stanhope.
Adios, future. Dionne was taking the Stanhopeless news better than I expected. Unless she's still in denial. And that means she could crack at any moment. Uh-oh. Crackage.
Just what the...
Beep! You are talking kookaroo. Do you even remember that day in third grade we vowed to go to college together? We pinky swore!
I totally forgot that I'd made a legally binding agreement.
Look, Dee, I know. But Daddy's a walking time bomb.
Is there any way you'd consider going local?
No can do. I've only been blessed with 18 years of tolerance from my mother.
Early morning, D cup. 9 wolf whistles, a dozen double takes, and the quad ground to an admiring halt. Sean, are you getting all this?
Oh, yeah. Monday, early morning.
Murray, I'd like to kick this up a notch after lunch. Have my Anna Nicole's ready.
Okay.
Man, only Amber could suck the fun out of breasts.
Hey, Amber, something looks different. Did you get a haircut?
No, wait. Something looks bigger. Is it your butt?
Catty girl displays obvious jealousy and makes a nasty remark.
Catty girl.
So, word's out that Mother Charissa can't bear to leave the maelster. I guess you two won't be having your panties raided at Bobsy Twin U.
Mother Teresa, no panties?
Look, it's just until his health improves.
Oh, please, he is the poster boy for Fatburger. If you really want to get out of there, you need to get Mel shacked up with someone.
Teddy's been single for more than 16 years. I hardly think he's going to get shacked up with somebody before fall semester.
Why not? Sean, take a letter. TPA.
TPA?
Totally prominent attorney. Seeks FLGP, fun-loving gal pal who doesn't mind the life of luxury, unlimited travel, and tons of money.
A personal ad, that's crazy.
We won't mention the OPD. Overprotective daughter.
Cher, the only thing that's crazy is us not going to college together. Look, I know this is important, but there is no way I'm taking out a personal ad for my father.
You didn't say I couldn't.
How could you go behind my back like that?
Cher, it's desperate times. I had to do desperate things.
Oh, so how'd you divide the letters? Geeks, freaks, and perverts?
Come on, have an open mind, please. Listen to this one. Her name is Bev. She loves classical music, sunsets, and long walks on the beach.
Psycho.
She also loves tennis, skiing, and anything athletic.
Way too butch.
She's a trainer and nutritionist for the LA Dodgers.
Wait a minute, let me see that. Says she just moved here from Seattle and hates the single scene. Look, she's on a mountain bike.
Eating granola.
Okay, hypothetically, and I'm not saying I'd go along with this, how would we get Daddy to go out with Bev?
Cinch. Hello, Bev. This is Mel Horowitz's secretary. He received your letter and would like to set up a date. How's tomorrow night at 7?
And what about Daddy?
Hi, Daddy! This woman named Bev called. She's a new client, and she needs you to draft her will. She's only available tomorrow night at 7, so I made it a dinner. I hope that's okay.
I think he knows you.
Okay, so maybe you could make that call.
Well, that'd work. Hold it. Eventually, they'll discover this was a setup and there was no will.
Cher, you're being logical. It makes your arms look fat.
Thank you. Mel?
Bev, nice to meet you.
You too. I've really been looking forward to this.
Really? Most people dread it.
Oh, so you've done this before?
Oh, dozens of times.
I haven't.
Relax. You're in good hands.
How comforting.
So are you married?
Well, of course not.
Well, it's no biggie for me. You're just another form.
So you keep records?
Oh, I have to. I do this so often, if I didn't have notes, I couldn't remember one from the other.
Okay. This date's officially over.
Date? Who said anything about a date?
Oh, you're right. It isn't a date, really, is it?
Excuse me?
You want to take me right here on the table, big fella?
Obviously, there has been a misunderstanding.
You're damn right there has. I thought that I was answering the personal ad of a gentleman. Go to hell, Mel. That was not supposed to rhyme.
Do you validate?
Hey, excuse me, sir. Listen. Would you be more attracted to this woman if she had big pouty lips?
Well, I guess that's a no-go on the pouty lips.
Sean, this whole thing is a no-go.
Hey, it's important that we study my features under varying lighting conditions.
Okay. Well, I can save you the trouble. You look better in the dark.
Fine, Flunkenstein, you are off the project.
Whatever.
Murray. No project, no grade, no graduate.
Okay.
All right, come on. Chop, chop, back to work.
Hey, buddy.
Hey.
Now, do you find this woman appealing, or would you be more interested in a woman with bigger breasts? Ooh.
Okay. Let's discuss dorm room decor.
It's crucial we stay current.
True. So I say we redecorate each semester.
Excellent, eh?
We'll help keep our mind off those annoying finals.
Ugh, do you have to say that?
Do you like that?
I like it.
Yeah. Uh-oh. Daddy's home at 8-ish. This bode's bad.
Why? Maybe he's just stopping off for an overnight bag and a toothbrush. Or not.
Hey, girls! Hey, I heard the strangest story today. Two people meet at this restaurant. One of them thinks he's there to write a will. The other one thinks she has answered a personal ad. You stop me if you think you know how this ends.
With a playful wine fight?
No.
Uh-oh. Awkward family moment. Q to D hit the road. You know how I hate getting involved in other people's business. Total disaster, huh?
Total. What were you thinking?
I don't know. It was a dumb idea.
That part's obvious. Why were you trying to play matchmaker?
I'm sorry. I was being totally selfish.
How?
Well, I just thought that maybe if you met someone you really liked, then just forget it.
No. What?
That I could go to Stanhope with Dee.
Is that what this is about? You're afraid you can't go away to college because of me?
Daddy, I was gone for one weekend and look what happened. Your cholesterol shot up a million points. I don't want to come home to a dead daddy.
Oh, man. Look, sweetheart, you are free to go wherever your life takes you. Now promise me you know that, and I promise you I will start taking better care of myself.
Really?
Really? I haven't been motivated enough to do it for myself, but I am definitely motivated enough to do it for my little girl. And please, stop feeling like you have to mother me.
Daddy, you're the only mother I've really ever had, so I kind of learned from the best.
That was the sweetest thing I've ever eavesdropped on.
Oh, God, I hope not.
Come on.
Please tell this guy that we're not pimps.
They're not pimps.
Yeah, and tell them that I am not a hooker.
They're not pimps.
Just put down, we consider it an honor just to be nominated.
Bonjour, ladies. Finance soon, Dom Pérignon.
Oh, look, it's Amber de Pardope.
Sorry to interrupt your little flea dip, but the suspense is over. I've decided to go to Europe.
So you're gonna pass on the plastic surgery?
Yes. I have decided that it is degrading for women to try to live up to some image that doesn't exist. And I love myself just the way I am.
Insane?
Ignoring.
Amber, I think you made the right choice.
Duh. If I do my boobs now, I will have nothing to save the marriage later.
Thank you.